Last week also the same.
Five minutes. Like a break.
That's why I didn't invest. It's still.
Oh, that's right. Now, when you say to
on the face.
Yeah, no, they're good. No, we have.
Do you have a spray meter?
Yeah, now. 5:30.
So there is really a third
we do have.
Okay.
No, no, no.
We have. They're in force.
But now our church is empty. Okay. If it is full, only outside. Go that way. If you don't have reservation, maybe ask them. Take the empty pews. The empty pew there. Tabernacle side. Oh, she's sleeping. Good afternoon. No, just put it there, you guys.
We'll stay until 5 minutes, now it's 5 minutes. So not till 7. Until 6:35, it records everything. So after mass, last night we were chatting, and then I saw it, we recorded that one. You know what I said tonight?
That's why I pop it now.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Today's my birthday. Can you give her a birthday blessing?
After the mass.
Yeah.
After the mass. God bless you. After the mass. Happy birthday. We are missing your birthday party.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to our Eucharistic celebration. Please rise. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. I wait to welcome the lost and lonely to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
Welcome to everyone to take part in this Holy Eucharistic celebration and ask for God's blessing. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we have gathered here as a God's family, let us acknowledge our sins and ask our Lord's pardon and mercy and forgiveness to take part in this Holy Eucharist.
Kyrie eleison. Oh,
Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down, and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows, and bread to the one who eats. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the spirits, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you.
On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. Such a large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down. And the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground, where it had little soil. It sprang up at once because the soil was not deep. And when the sun rose it, and it was scorched, and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit, 100, 60, or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit. 100, 60, or 30-fold, says the Lord. Good evening, my brothers and sisters. It is written in the book of Revelation, in the Bible, which says, blessed are those who read the Bible, which means the Word of God, who reads the Word of God, who listens to the Word of God, who meditate over the Word of God, and all those who live according to the Word of God are so blessed, he says. Blessed are those, all those who listen to the Word of God, and those who read the Bible, the Word of God, and who blessed are those who meditate upon the Word of God, and those who live according to the Word of God. Yes, my brothers and sisters, today Jesus, he is teaching us in a parable, in a separate way, in a special way, and he is using a simple parable of a sower and a seed. If we know something about farming and plowing and so on, cultivation, that we can understand very clearly what Jesus is telling us. But here, the gospel passage, Jesus right away, he began saying that a sower went out to sow a seed in the field. But he did not mention what happened before that. It was not given in the Bible. It was not given in the gospel. But Jesus right away says that a sower has gone out to sow a seed in the field. But my brothers and sisters, much before that, we need a preparation. The preparation of the land for the cultivation. Without preparing the land for cultivation, we can't sow a seed. So a farmer who, first of all, he has to plow the land and he has to take out all the weeds from there, and then the sunshine, the land receives the sunshine and the oxygen goes inside and the land is ready for fertile. And then, after having done all this, a farmer starts sowing a seed. And he has to, after that, he has to manure it, he has to water it, and he has to make a fence around it to protect from other animals or the wild animals, and he has to protect from the birds, otherwise the birds will come and pick them. So he has to take care of all these things. So all these Jesus has not mentioned, but he thought that it is given to us. The preparation is given to us. We have to make the preparation. But it is the right duty of the farmer or the sower. He is ready to sow a seed. As Jesus explained the parable to his disciples, that the seed is nothing but the Word of God. A sower is none other than God himself. And the soil is nothing but our hearts, our human hearts and our human minds. So now the preparation is up to us. How to make the preparation? If you want to produce more fruit, you need to have a good preparation for the sower. If you don't have a preparation, and you are not going to produce any fruit, because it has to, the soil has to be ready. So therefore, Jesus, what he meant when he was telling to his people, his listeners, that you have to prepare your land, your soil, your hearts to receive the Word of God. to receive that seed. So Jesus, he classified all the listeners, those who are there, into four groups, or in general, he made into four groups. Like the first one is people like the seed fell on the path side, on a pathway. The second group of people are like the seed which is fell on the rocky ground. And the third group of people are like a seed which is fell among the thorns. And the fourth group of people are like a seed which is sown on the rich soil, the good soil, which brings good fruit. And now, the first three groups of people, are they going to produce much fruit? Not at all. Why? Because all these, the first one, with the seed which fell on the pathway, it is gone. Because the people walk through that way, it is gone. Because there is no weeds, there is no roots, there is no soil on that. It is hard, so it is gone. They are not going to produce anything. Because our hearts are hardened. We are so hard, we are so stubborn. So such people are not going to produce any fruit. And the second group of people, like the rocky ground, it is also like our hearts are like a stone. But Jesus, as he mentions, even in the book of prophet Jeremiah, he says that, God says that, Lord, I am ready to give you a heart which is a flesh. I am ready to take out your stone heart. So my brothers and sisters, if we have that kind of stone heart, that kind of rocky ground is not going to produce any fruit. Even though the sower, God is sowing the word of God, but we are not receiving. It may fall on that rocky ground, on the stone, but it is going to wither it out. It's not going to produce anymore. Even the third group of people, if you would see what Jesus says, the seed fell among the thorns. These thorns grew up, the bushes, it becomes bushes, and that chokes up, and that it choked everything. There is no sunshine, it is all dark, and the water is not going entering inside, and it is very difficult to manure it. So this also, no way, this kind of people are not going to produce any fruit. So therefore, Jesus, he wants every one of us to be like the rich soil. Our hearts should be rich soil, which is ready, which we have the good preparation in our hearts to receive the word of God. Receive Jesus into our hearts. If you are ready for that, and then we are going to receive or produce much fruit. And that fruit, or the everything in abundance. That's like what Jesus says, 100-fold, 60-fold, or 30-fold. You see, the up to 100-fold, the measure is 30, 60, and 100. So now, it is up to us. We are all belong to God. We all belong to Jesus. And we all have received baptism. At the time of baptism, we received the Holy Spirit. And if you have received the Holy Spirit, if it is there in your heart, and that soil should be a rich soil. And if you don't realize, if you don't recognize that the Holy Spirit is in you, and you are not going to bear much fruit. So today, as Jesus is asking us to prepare our soil, our hearts, to receive the word of God. This word of God is nothing but, as St. John in his gospel, in the first chapter, first verse, where he said, in the beginning there was a word. The word was with God. The word was God. And the same word has become flesh. And the same word lived among us. That word is none other than Jesus Christ, who is the Son of God, begotten Son of God. So, if you want to receive Jesus into your hearts, into your soil, and be ready, prepare well, and then bear much fruit, so that you will become a real children of God. So, therefore, today during this Holy Mass, let us ask for God's blessing. And let us ask the Lord to give us strength that we may become a rich soil to receive Jesus into our hearts, that word of God, which bears much fruit and gives us in abundance, not only for ourselves and for all of others and everyone who is our neighbor and everybody, so that God will bless every one of us. Amen. Please rise. Let us profess our faith by reciting the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, as people of God's holy word, let us pray for all who are in need.
For openness in the church to God's generous and life-giving word, let us pray to the Lord. For an end to hunger throughout the world through a generous sharing of the planting and harvesting from every nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer in the heat, for those who endure storms, fires, and floods, and for all who respond to their needs with generous hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For migrant workers and for immigrants, as they strive for a better life for themselves and for their families, let us pray to the Lord. For the health and safety of all in our communities as we continue to reopen in the wake of the pandemic, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, especially NNN, and for all who suffer from COVID-19, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially Alice de Mesa Sansalian, Villarreal Temo, Jesus Manuel Ramos, and Virginia Marufo, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Today is my mother's death anniversary. I would request you all to pray for her, that the good Lord may grant her eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord. Gracious and generous God, your word of salvation has been spread over the world. Help it to bear fruit in our lives, and hear all these our prayers through Christ our Lord. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that, when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Osea, Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord. Thank you for celebrating with us tonight, and may God bless you all and all your family members. A special thanks to MOH members and the cantor, lector, and the pianist, and to everyone. And thanks to our cameraman. God bless him. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace of Christ and glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
God bless you. Have a wonderful week.
Come before you now, hungry for your healing touch. Here we stand with open hearts, thirsting for your love. You are the one who feels our every need, so with one voice we in unity, one bread, one cup, one body of Christ, united in love. One bread, one cup, one living sacrifice, poured out in your blood. As we gather at your table, broken like the bread we share, fill our hearts with your compassion for a world in need of care. You are the way, you are the life, you are the truth, the source of our salvation. We find new life in you. One bread, one cup, one body of Christ, united in love. One bread, one cup, one living sacrifice, poured out in your blood. Holy Spirit, renew us, that in each other we may see you. Gather us one family in love, one bread, one cup. When we go forth from this place of perfect peace, for all the world to see.
You can close. Yeah. Put in all one and empty ones? Are they empty? Dennis, are they empty? No, these, yeah. Oh, empty, leave them on that fuse. Give me away. Thank you.
See you Thursday.
They forgot to in the paper. Good night, thank you.
It's so hot up there.
Well, sure, the new lights, I don't have anything up there.